Mr. Prime Minister, members, this is not a game. I take my job very seriously. I looked around, and the only microphone that was on was the Prime Minister's microphone. Anybody putting on a microphone now is going to make a mockery of the House, and they will face the wrath of the Speaker. Thank you.
Mr. Speaker, on the point of order, may I?
May you do what?
On the point of order, may I?
What is the point of order?
Mr. Speaker, we're here to debate a very important bill.
What is the point of order?
That it's 3 o'clock. We've not even had one recess. We're here, two people alone, trying to cover all of the speeches, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Leader of the Opposition, what is the point of order?
I was expecting that the leader was getting up to give us a break. I see other members in the House who also want to speak. I would still like my turn to speak, Mr. Speaker.
I have said continuously that we are bound by the standing orders. The standing orders are clear, pellucid, and unambiguous, that whoever catches the eye of the speaker shall be the person called upon to speak. A review of the cameras will show I turned in both directions, and the only microphone that was on was that of the Prime Minister. This is not a subject for debate. I have ruled. The Prime Minister and Minister of Finance will close the debate now.
This is the incident that led to opposition leader Allen Chastanet accusing the SLP administration of denying him the opportunity to make his contribution in the House of Assembly and preventing the public from hearing about the proposals contained in the budget, which he believes will affect them negatively. According to the opposition leader, it has become customary that at every budget debate, the leader of the opposition brings to the attention of the government and the general public the issues and concerns stemming from the proposals and expenses contained in the budget.
I did stand on a point of order and asked the speaker for his intervention, indicating to him I saw that there were other persons in the House who wanted to speak, and certainly I wanted to be able to speak. And I thought that when the Prime Minister got up, that what he was getting up to do was to ask for recess or for lunch break. It is within the Speaker's prerogative to make the determination. I know that one of the responsibilities the Speaker has is to protect the minority. Certainly, when I was Prime Minister, Andy Daniel, when he was Speaker of the House, on several occasions, although I had risen first, afterwards noticed members of the opposition who wanted to speak, and he asked me to sit down.
This time, according to him, the ruling party sacrificed Castries South MP and Investment and Tourism Minister Dr. Ernest Hilaire, along with Labrie MP and Foreign Affairs and Civil Aviation Minister Alva Baptiste, as well as Castries Central MP Richard Frederick, who is also the Housing and Local Government Minister.
At the end of the day, I was denied again the opportunity to speak, and as I said, three senior ministers were sacrificed in order to prevent me from speaking, which is very undemocratic.
The opposition leader will be making his budget rebuttal Tuesday evening at 8 p.m. in an address to the nation. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.